Columbus discovered America in 1492. Then came the English and the Dutch, the Frenchman and the Jews. Then came the Swede and the Irishman, who helped the country grow. Still they keep a-coming, and now everywhere you go, there's the Argentines and the Portuguese, the Armenians and the Greeks. One sells you papers, one shines your shoes, another shaves the whiskers off your cheeks. When you ride again in a subway train, notice who have all the seats. And you'll find they are held by the Argentines and the Portuguese and the Greeks. There's the Ritz Hotel and the Commodore and the Vanderbilt and the rest. All of them are classy, up-to-date hotels. They boast accommodations of the best. When you ask the clerk for a room and bath, he looks at you sarcastically and speaks, why, we're all filled up with the Argentines and the Portuguese and the Greeks. There's the Oldsmobile and the Humpmobile and the Cadillac and the Ford. They are the motors you and I can own, the kind most anybody can afford. But the Cunningham and the Mercedes and the Rolls-Royce Racing 3, they all belong to the Argentines and the Portuguese and the Greeks. There are pretty girls, there are pretty girls, there is every kind of a girl. Some you like a little, some a little more, but none of them will set your heart awhirl. When you really feel you've met your ideal, a girl who is smart and chic, you will find she belongs to an Argentine, or a Portuguese, or a Greek. There's the Argentine and the Portuguese, the Armenian and the Greek. They don't know the language, they don't know the law, but they vote in the country of the free. And the funny thing, when we start to sing, my country is a sea. None of us know the words but the Argentine and the Portuguese and the Greek.